Hello watch fans, it's Anders here on Watch On Channel. Today I'm back with a review of a new Spinnaker dive watch. In fact, it's a new version of an existing line of dive watches within the collection of Spinnaker watches. It is the Spence, the new version of the Spence. And this is a kind of tactical, very tool watch-like dive watch from Spinnaker. If you're interested in buying this watch, you can find the link down below. Remember to use the code WATCHON20 when you're checking out. This means that you will get 20% off, which means that this $285 watch is actually only $228. So just to disclose everything, I will get a percentage if you use the WATCHON20 code if you want to support the channel if you're buying any product on the Spinnaker website, just to get all of that out of the way. And of course also the code down below in the description so you can find it down there. So the Spence, the new version of the Spence, comes in three different versions: this black version, a blue version, and a kind of brownish version. I got the black version here. So what we have is a 42 millimeter dive watch in diameter, including the crown, 14 millimeters, 13 and a half in thickness, lug width of 22, and from lug to lug we get 46, 47. So all in all, very nice dimensions, kind of classic dive watch dimensions with the 42 millimeters, the just below 50 millimeters from lug to lug, and the 20 or 22 millimeter lug width, as well as under 15 millimeters in the thickness of the watch. It is a stainless steel case, but it's bead blasted, so you get this kind of titanium look, but it is actually a stainless steel, 316L stainless steel. It comes with the Seiko NH35A movement, and once again, I have been a lucky son of a bitch with one of these Seiko movements, because let's just have a look at how accurate this watch actually is. So as you can see, very, very lucky. It's between 4 and 6 seconds plus, so it's actually within COSC specifications, which is quite amazing with these kind of affordable movements. That is the biggest kind of movement type used in a lot of smaller brands. So Spinnaker are actually really growing really fast. They're just putting out watches and straps and bracelets, and I actually also got some straps and nasal straps I'm going to show you just in a few seconds to show how you can actually change the whole look of the watch. It's a Lume monster, and why not just have a look at the Lume right now? As you can see, it's absolutely a Lume monster. It just glows, and it's both the hands, the hour markings, the hour dots, and also the markings on the 120 click bezel insert, aluminium bezel insert, that actually is a Lume monster. And let me just again show you how it looks on my wrist, but just show you in kind of not too sharp artificial light in my house, you can see that it still actually glows really, 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 really nicely. So that's an absolutely Lume monster we got in our hands right here. So the bezel is super tight. It's super, super nice. The click is very, very nice. Absolutely no play. And a 120 click unidirectional dive watch bezel. It's aluminium. And as I said, all these dots here, all the markings are actually lumed. So you get applied hour markings or Arabic numerals for the hours, 1 to 12. Applied Spinnaker logo and printed is automatic, and as we can see down here, 200 meters of water resistance. We get a date window at 3 o'clock. Usually I'm not a big fan of these black on white date windows, but somehow it actually turns out really nicely on this watch. It works just fine. Signed crown. And a really nice detail with this watch is that this is a super big and easy to grip and operate crown. It really makes it a very, very easy watch to operate, and it's super, super easy to grip. It has the thickness and the knurling, and it's just super easy to operate. And as you see, this movement has hacking and manually winding. So having a look at the dial, you get this very nice textured dial, as we also saw on the hull. You can find the link down below or in the right upper hand corner if you want to see the review of the Spinnaker hull. As you can see, we get this very nice textured, almost kind of, it maybe resembles asphalt or maybe the lunar surface. It just really gives some a nice look and dimension to the dial with the applied numerals. So you get a very kind of simple watch, At first, when you glance at this watch, it looks very simple, but when you get more into the details, it's actually kind of a nice dimension you have to the dial, in my opinion. So the hands are the Mercedes hands, the Baton minute hand, Mercedes hour hand, and a Lollipop second hand, so a nice combination. This is of course mostly known from Rolex, but this is in no way an homage watch to the Rolex watches. A lot of other watch brands are also using the Mercedes hands, the what is called the Mercedes hand, which is actually made this way to be able to have a lot of Lume in it. As you can see on the Lume picture, the video I showed you just before, you can see that it really lights up like a torch. It's a see-through case back, sapphire crystal as far as I know. I have seen both sapphire and mineral crystal, but I'm not quite sure which one it is, but it's definitely holding up very nicely, completely flat, which just makes this watch look much more modern and kind of a tactical dive watch compared to the more domed crystals. As you see on the pictures now, when I am wearing the watch outside on my 18 centimeter wrist in circumference, you can see I can easily pull off these 42 millimeters. To me, it wears a little bit thick, but on the other side, it also wears a little bit smaller than 42 millimeters, so it feels more like a 41 millimeter watch. So a lot of people should be able to wear this watch without any problem. It comes on this nice leather strap with a Tang buckle, which is also signed with Spinnaker. This is treated with a treatment which makes it kind of water resistant, so you actually get a very, very nice, soft, very, very comfortable leather strap, which is also able to handle some water. So that's definitely a big plus as well. So it comes in these typical blue Spinnaker boxes. I'm not going to show you much more about this box because you know it if you have seen all the other Spinnaker reviews I have done. So here at the end of the review, just to show you that Spinnaker also produced their own nice leather straps, which you can buy separately, also with a 20% discount if you use the watch on 20 code, so you can get these at very nice prices. I think this actually makes the watch look a little more dressy or a little more upscale, even though it is a tool watch. This is a very nice leather strap with a rubber inlay, so you can actually wear this leather strap and not destroy it with the sweat and the oils from your skin, because it's rubber inside, so you can also easily clean it. Another choice could be this very nice kind of tropical strap, making it look almost kind of more of a vintage watch, in my opinion. This is rubber, of course, so it's very easy to clean and it won't get destroyed from water and stuff like that. So this also makes the watch look really, really cool. So a third choice could be the rubber NATO strap, and I think that's actually also a cool look. It gives a little more color to the watch, in my opinion, with this green rubber strap. So all in all, you heard my opinion in this video. I really like this watch. This is definitely so far the best Spinnaker watch I have experienced, both with the accuracy, the wearability, and the overall quality and finish. I really, really like this Spence watch. Again, you can get this watch at 20% discount. It costs $285, but if you use the code WATCHON20, you can find the code and the link to the Spinnaker website down in the description down below, then you can get this watch at less than $230. So that's actually a really good deal. This is by far better than any watches below $500 than Seiko, for example, can produce. And it actually has a Seiko movement, so that's kind of a funny thing. I overall really, really enjoy this watch. It is a very tooly watch, so it's not a watch you can wear and at any occasion, in my opinion, but it is a watch that you can definitely wear at the beach during the weekend, or if you're going to do the garden, or you're going on a hike, or going on vacation, and something like that. Not a super original watch, but all in all, a nice package, and I don't really have too much bad to say about a watch at this price, with this accuracy, this extreme lume, and this very nice finishing, and this very nice dial. So I hope you enjoyed my review of the Spinnaker Spence, the new version, 2019 version. If you enjoyed it, please remember to subscribe. I'm really trying to reach 10,000 subscribers, and it would be a really, really big help if you subscribe to my channel. Also, remember to share my videos with your friends on the forums, on the Facebook groups, because that's a big help to get more exposure to my videos. Also remember to leave a comment down below, give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this review. I have a lot more coming. Follow me on Instagram and Facebook, and I will see you very soon again with more watch reviews. Thank you. Bye.